A word of warning before we get into this video. This particular episode is a compilation of clips filmed on an older Samsung phone. The content, therefore, will be very shaky and not of the highest quality. Those with weak stomachs or equilibriums might want to forgo this one. Also, please don't think the quality of this video is reflective of our channel in general. At least I hope it's not. The septic tank. Since we didn't do the installation ourselves, this video is not going to be a very detailed instructional, just basically an overview of the process. Septic tanks usually come in concrete or plastic. For this particular application, the contractor decided to use a two-part plastic tank. Nowadays, this could all be a DIY job, since these excavators can be rented, but having one installed, at least in our case, wasn't much more than the cost of renting the equipment and purchasing the tank and pipes needed. So it's something you might want to consider outsourcing too, if you even need a tank. If your house has an existing septic tank, it might already be large enough to support your garage apartment. Or, if you have city sewer, it's even easier. You just Y into the main line. The process is fairly simple. You basically dig a hole big enough for the tank, and deep enough so that the access openings are at ground level. The wastewater from your building goes into the inlet. And the overflow water from the tank goes out the outlet to the drain field, or in our case, to a distribution box that goes to a drain field. And it's important that your pipes in and out have a drop-in elevation of about 1/8 of an inch to 1/4 inch per foot. That's actually about all the footage we have for this episode, and again, we apologize for the quality. In the next video, we'll be starting our walls. Thanks as always for watching. We hope to see y'all again soon.